Hi, good afternoon, everyone. Thanks for joining. Today I'll be talking about making a career out of open source software testing. And by the way, I'm not Pavan. I work in Red Hat, Bangalore office, India. And I'm a principal quality engineer. So my main role is testing and checking the quality of software products in Red Hat. And I mainly work on cluster storage system. Yeah, so this is about me, and that was my latest photo in Český Krumlov. And it was amazing place. I have about 12 years work experience across enterprise storage, servers, and platform domain. I have been in Red Hat for the last 4 years, and I'm working as a principal quality engineer in Red Hat storage team. So the talk and its target audience. So this talk will make sense for anyone who wants to make a career in software testing and don't know where to start, how to start, and how do I get hands-on, get the real-time experience, and how do I use open source for doing the same. So open source is going to be the gateway of how I get my hands on testing a product, and this talk will be how to do that. And just a disclaimer, it is not a job offering, or it's not a promise of the same. It is not a definitive workflow. It is more of knowing how to start and explore, where to start exploring, and how you can use open source software to learn software testing. So before that, I have a few questions. How many of you know what is open source? Can you raise your hands? Quite a number. How many of you have contributed to open source? Pardon? Okay. How many have you contributed to open source? Okay. How many of you have contributed to Wikipedia? Okay. And how many of you have contributed to Wikipedia but not open source? Contributed to Wikipedia, editing the Wikipedia, but not to open source. Okay, 1%. Actually, you have contributed to open source. Wikipedia is also open source, just for information. So if you are editing Wikipedia pages, congratulations, you have started already contributing to open source. Okay? Okay, why did I choose to speak about this topic? Before joining Red Hat, even I didn't have much open source exposure. I was recruited into Red Hat for my storage knowledge and my platform and enterprise skills. But still, however, I had majorly contributed to open source through editing Wikipedia pages. That was my interest. I used to edit Wikipedia pages, anything on India, anything on politics of India, or even cricket. How football is famous in Europe, cricket is famous in the Indian subcontinent. So those were my contributions to open source. And surprisingly, after I joined Red Hat, I understood that it is very easy to contribute to open source. Before joining, even I was, if someone would have given a talk, I would be sitting on the other side thinking, how can I contribute? Hence, seeing what I've learned in the last 4 years, I would like to take this opportunity to explain how you can learn software testing through open source or contribute to open source. So what is open source? I've just taken this definition from Wikipedia. I'm not going to read the definition. You have the time to read it. However, open source is more described in the next page. It is more of free, as in free speech, not as in free beer. So open source means you can modify the code, you can modify the content, you can share the content. Based again, there are multiple licenses, which means it's like a free speech. You can talk anything. Similarly, you can code anything. You can share it with anything. You can talk as you talk with free speech. You can talk. And remember, it need not be as free in beer. No one is giving you anything for free. There can be free. You can get the product for free, but doesn't mean open source means free. Open source, I can sell a product using my open source license, but I can still make money out of it. So it need not always be someone is giving you a free product. It is more about the ideology and the ideas which is free. It need not be the product which is free. So for example, Red Hat generates revenue by selling open source software, which means the code is accessible, the code is free to your access. However, we sell subscriptions and support and test. We test the product. That's how Red Hat makes money. So which means it's not necessarily free. It can be free, it need not be free. Okay, how many of you are aware of what is software testing? That's a good number. So in simple terms, in my definition, software testing is just checking a software product, or be it testing or quality. I may be using the terms interchangeably, quality test, quality or testing, or test engineer or a quality engineer. It's one and the same. It is to check a piece of software whether it is working as expected. So there are two parts to it. One is validation and one is verification. Validation is checking if you have built the product right. That means, is the product meeting the expectations what was set in the specifications? Okay, and it does the specifications meet the requirements? Let's think, as a customer, I have told you to build a product A. When I build the product, is it, have I built the product A, or have I ended up building a product something which is not A? That is validation. Whereas verification, it is checking if I have built the product in the rightly, in the sense, is A working as expected, or can there be improvements to A? That is what it is. So here, when I talk about verification, it is more about that, does the product meet the specifications? So first I get the requirements, then I build specifications out of the requirements. When you map the specifications to the requirements, it is validation. And when you check whether your specifications have been met, is verification. It can be a little bit confusing, but you'll get it over time. So firstly, when I talk about quality engineer, firstly, how does it feel to be a quality engineer? So the perks of being a quality engineer, or what do you enjoy by making a career in software engineer as a quality engineer? You get to be the gatekeeper of quality of a product and to the shipment of the product. So it's the quality engineering team which decides whether a product is worth shipping it or we should not be shipping it. If we feel the product is still not bug free, there are a lot of severe bugs, then we have the right, we have to use our veto power to tell we should not be switching the shipping this product, because if the customer installs this product, it's going to be, they're going to face problems, and then it's going to be a bad reputation on the product itself. You get to better the product with awesome quality, and always remember, it's always good to have a decent product with very good quality rather than having a innovative and great product but not having quality. There have been many companies and many products which have failed because of, they may be very innovative, but there is lack of quality. And so quality engineering, and even software engineering for that matter, you can debate whether, first of all, is software engineering, is it an engineering stream or is it an art stream? So there are people who don't agree that software engineering is an engineering stream because it doesn't follow any of the Newton's laws, it doesn't follow any physics, it doesn't follow gravity. Some talk it like it is an art because it requires more of a creativity, and it requires you to think outside the rules and define it. So it's left to you what you want to make out of software engineering. So whereas quality engineering is more to do with, again, a mix of this. First, it's an art where you need to exercise your interest and be creative on how you can break the product. Also, you need to know the technology. Like, first you need to have a broad picture of the technology, and then only you, when you know about a product, let's take a simple product, maybe a mobile phone. I first need to understand what is the purpose of this mobile phone. Once at least at a high level I understand what a mobile phone is, then you start to break the product, in the sense, is the phone doing what I expected it to do? Is it having any problems, when you start being curious or inquisitive about it, then you start getting into testing the product. You feel this product can be improved in so and so manner. That's all part of quality engineering. What is required to be a software quality engineer? It's just your interest. That's the most important thing for anything. You just need interest, interest, and interest. And you need to have the curiosity to explore a product. As I told you, you want to test a mobile product. You need to have the curiosity to test how the product works. You need to know what buttons are for what. What if I switch the wrong buttons? Will it really impact my product like those? So you need to be curious. And you need to have a desire to keep learning. Now, when there is a new update to the product, what does the new update brings to this? Is it breaking something or is it improving it? If it is improving it, how is it improving it? Now, so this is the main part. Where to start? So first thing is you need to understand what software testing is in detail. Software testing, I have told it at a high level what it is. It is like testing a product and finding if it is working as per the expectation and the specifications. However, you need to get more details into it. There are multiple courses. It can be through YouTube or whatever. And you need to understand many different levels in that. Like, for example, what is manual and what is automation testing? You can test a product manually. Like, for example, take a website. I want to log into the railway website of Czech Republic, that is cd.cz. Now I can test it manually, like if I enter the wrong username and wrong password, will it allow me to book the tickets? Or let's think I want to test it at a scale. Let's think today it's a holiday in Czech Republic, or the next day is a holiday in Czech Republic, let's assume, and everyone wants to log in and go to their native or go out of station. Now let's think if 1 lakh public is trying to log in, is the product going to scale to that? That I can't have 1 lakh audience go and test it. So I need to automate that. I will deploy a tool to automate that 1 lakh logins and see if that system can bear the stress. And so that's the difference between manual and automation. Again, you need to understand what are the levels and methods of testing. Example, unit testing, integration testing, and system level testing. How does the system work when I integrate with different applications? Also, what's the difference between functional and non-functional? You need to know. Simple example, in the just when I quoted, the functional testing is checking if your login is working well or not. Non-functional can be breaking the system. It can be doing something which is not functional. You're going beyond, like checking if 1 lakh logins, can the system take 1 lakh logins or 1 million logins. And to start with, okay, so all this can be complicated. Now, where do I start with? The simplest and easiest way is start with the documentation. Find a product, see if you can read the documentation, if you can understand the product, and you think the documentation can be improved. That itself is you have started your journey to testing a product. You're testing, you're doing documentation testing, which is also a testing. It's called static testing, where you read the documentation and you can even improve the product there itself. Okay, so the most important part to continue or to explore software testing is you should be able to raise your first bug. A bug is a anomaly in the product. So if my mobile application for some reason it's not logging in after even I enter the right credentials, it means there is a problem. It's an anomaly which needs to be fixed. And how do you fix it? By raising a bug. And for that, you need to understand what is a bug life cycle and software development life cycle. And remember, your first bug is going to be critical to boost your confidence in, are you on the right path? Or you need at every point of time in life, you need to boost yourself and you need confidence. So even a small bug, like let's think even there is a typo in the documentation or there is a typo in the man pages, raise a bug on that product and that will really boost immense confidence in you. And that's the first bug is generally a memorable one for any test engineer, and you'll cherish that. It can be a simple bug. There is nothing like a good or a bad bug. It's about a bug. It just needs to be valid. So now all I've talked about, but how do I use open source projects to learn? So first you need to do is choose an area of interest. Example, are you interested in databases? Are you interested in front-end technologies? Are you interested in back-end? For example, I am interested in storage and networking. So choose which one you are interested in. If you are interested in, for example, database, maybe choose a MongoDB, choose Couchbase. There are many open source technologies. If you are interested in storage, there is Ceph, there is Gluster. If you are really interested in platform and kernel, then you can choose the Linux kernel itself. Then after that, the next step is find out if there are open source technologies in the areas of your interest. And you'll be surprised to know there are many, or you will have an answer. Every domain has an open source technology. For example, as I just told, if you want to contribute to kernel and operating systems, there is Fedora, there is Ubuntu. If you want to contribute to storage, there is Gluster, there is Ceph. All these are open source projects. So once you find out that, you just need to visit their website and their GitHub page. GitHub is where you do the coding and you share the code. It's like code lifecycle is maintained through that. Visit that website and join their user list and development list or any other mailing list. Once you are done that, go through the documentation. How did I learn Gluster? For example, I went through the documentation of the product, installed it, saw if I was able to install it easily. Is it really matching the documentation what I read through? Was I able to follow the same steps and was I able to install the same product as is? If I weren't, then if I have a hindrance in a certain step, I reach out to the user list who are always helpful in the open source community. You just need to send a mail to them and they will reply. And now if you think there was a step missing, you can raise a first bug. You can tell you need to add this extra step to make the documentation easy. And now once you have done with the installation and you've got your hands on it, it's now start testing the product. It's like, for example, is my storage product really scaling? Am I able to add disks to it? Am I able to remove storage from it? Is it working as expected? Everything will be mentioned in the documentation. You need to read that and you'll start getting a hands-on and a feel of the documentation of the product itself. And once you start exploring and once you start getting into this product, over a few months of time, you'll be able to understand the product, and now you know how to make the product better. And surely you can see that there will be a lot of scope for improving the product and you need to raise bugs for it. Okay, these are all part of the manual part where you do this manually. But what if I'm interested in automation, that is coding? I want to code how to test the product, not necessarily the product code itself, but I want to code some certain automation scripts to make the life easy. Like I would want to test a login page, but I don't want to test it every time. I want to have it automated. So I can use Python. So first you need to know is find out if that product has an automation framework. Surely most of them have. And if they have, see what is the language they use. For example, some products use Gluster, some products use Python, some use Go, some use Perl, some use just bash scripting. So if you are comfortable in one of those or you want to explore that, that's a place to learn. Go through the framework. The code is open. Everyone can go through the code. Like in the previous company for which I worked, the code was accessible only to the employees of the company. Whereas in open source, that's the beauty of it. You get to see the code. You know how it flows. So see through the code. Write your first simple program. It can be as simple as checking a login page, whether I'm able to connect and log in, or check the help of it and see if you can contribute to the automation. How does this benefit? So if I were to talk when compared with a closed source company, like in the previous company I would have worked, if I wanted to have a hands-on on testing a product, I wouldn't, because I don't know what the product is. I don't have access to the product itself. But with the open source communities, now you get a platform to have a real-time experience in testing a software product. and you can contribute to the open source community. What does this get you? It first gives you confidence on how to test a product, whether you think software testing can make a career for you. Do you think it's worth exploring that? You also get an opportunity to network and learn with many open source experienced community members. That is through the mailing chains, which I've talked about previously, that is the users list or the devil list. You can prove yourself, which may lead to one of the community members recognizing and even offering an internship or a job. Just think, if you're continuously contributing to a product in the open source community, let's think you're filing a lot of very critical and important bugs over time. Or if you're even automating and writing automation scripts for the community, which are really being used by others, then who knows, the community member and the maintainer may even see if there is a job opportunity and may request or may offer you a job or an interview. Also, over time, if you think, yeah, why not explore developing the product itself, then you can even try exploring switching roles in other areas like software development, where you develop the code of the product itself and the design of the product. You can be a community moderator or a maintainer who maintains the community, or you think, I'm better at doing documentation or content development. I feel I can develop the content better and in a more lucid manner for anyone to understand. You can be a content development engineer also. Now, how do I just take this? I'll just take this example of Gluster, which I've been working on. So, and how do I use it, or how do I connect with the open source to really contribute to it? So first, in this case, I've chosen a storage system, storage file system. That's my area of interest. Now, what do I do, as I told in the previous page? You choose an area of interest, I've chosen it. Now, find out if there are an open source technology in the interest. I've chosen storage domain. Yes, there are. You browse and you'll get to know Gluster, there is Ceph, there are multiple, there is VDO, there is Data Optimizer, many. Now, I pick Gluster. Now, what do I do in the next thing? Go to their website. Just go to gluster.org. And if you go to the web page, you get every information, like how you can read the documentation. There is community information. How do I become part of the community? How do I subscribe to the mailing list, like Gluster users and Gluster devil? And also you get to read and understand the product. You can go to their documentation. And then once you have a hands-on on that, the documentation also explains you how to install or how to perform admin operations. And once you're done that, you start getting hands-on on that product. Once over time, like maybe a couple of months, based on your time and interest and your bandwidth, once you start getting into that product, see how you can improve the product. And as you'll be following the Gluster users and devil list, you'll be able to see many community members who are using this application or this product. They reach out with questions. They reach out with questions on how to use the product, or can I use the product in a better way, or can this product fit my solution or not. Once you start reading and trying to seep in information from that, you'll start knowing what the product is, and that will help you prepare for even testing the product. And also you get to participate in the community meetings, which can happen weekly once, and that helps you in networking and knowing other people ideas, and their, when you once start collaborating with them. And also you get to know, if in this case, if there is an automation framework, yes, there is GlustoTest. You can contribute to that through coding through Python. Yeah, that's it. Any questions and answers? Questions? Yeah, please.
Yeah, I just wanted to mention Fedora community also organizes Fedora test days.
Yes.
It's a good way to participate in testing.
Yes.
Subsystem.
Yes.
Fedora, like QML, PU.
Yes.
Networking.
Yes.
Yes,
that's a very good point. Thanks for bringing that. So if you I've chosen an example of Gluster, but Fedora is probably a better example. It it's an exposure to the operating system itself, and there are many layers. It can be at the kernel level or it can be at the user level. It can be even if you are installing the browser, is it working well or not, you can participate in the test days. Fedora has it whenever there is almost a new release. Every release before that, they have test days where you can participate there, and they also instruct you how to participate and how to be active there. So feel free to reach out and reach out to Fedora mailing list. You don't have to held back by thinking what is it. You just need to join the test days and they will be there to help you. And that will be a very good starting point to start exploring and testing your product. Thank you.
I'm sorry for interrupting.
Yeah. Okay. Any other questions, you can please reach out to me. Anything else you want to talk, anything which is not clear, please reach out. Thanks for your time.